I hope you're all pumped and excited for tonight's Life Crusher Live. Although my little light's not really... Hang on, guys. I need to adjust my lighting. Can you see me better now? How are you all doing out there? I hope you're all crushing it today. I've got an interesting subject area to talk about, and I'm sure that you can all relate. When my reminder messages went out, I was having a bit of a cackle to myself when I put out all people get little alerts when Psych Chrissy is going to go live each week. Hey, Caitlin. Hey, David. Welcome back, David. I haven't seen you in a few weeks. But basically, there were little alerts that went out, and tonight's subject is about, do you sometimes flip out at people or situations for no apparent reason? I'm going to talk to you a little bit about that because, contrary to probably popular opinion, there's always a reason. And in fact, you know that saying that people have that, oh, he or she just goes from 0 to 10 in 2 seconds flat. It may seem that way, but actually in reality, it doesn't work like that. So Psych Chrissy is going to talk to you guys. Hey, Cal, welcome to Life Crusher Live. Tonight we're talking about freaking out and why people tend to fly off the handle at what we would tend to say is relatively minor triggers or situations. But when I talk to you about, you know, the reasons for that, you'll really understand from a broad point of view, you know, what goes on for someone psychologically when they're having their minor flip out moments, which, look, we've all probably had. Even Psych Chrissy could admit to some flip out moments from time to time. But let's not dwell on that. Guys, on the post, we are kicking off the new or the next Mind Body Bootcamp. We've actually got Caitlin here, who is one of our Mind Body Bootcamp ambassadors. So if you want to come and work with Psych Chrissy a little bit more intensively, get your mind and your body all healthy, get really good results, because we know that our program is absolutely 100% kick ass, then come and join us on the next Mind Body Bootcamp, which is kicking off on October the 22nd. So click the link in the post, guys, if you want some more details around that, because we will certainly be looking for our next crew of people that want to change their lives. So if that's you, just want to get some help and support around healthy lifestyle, and you need a little bit of a kick in the butt to make that happen, come and join Psych Chrissy and Coach Mel's Mind Body Bootcamp. It's awesome. Anyway, let's get into flipping out, guys. So flipping out, aka losing your shit, being hypersensitive to a trigger in the environment. Hey, Amanda. Just getting angry or letting someone receive a whole amount of, what could we say, maybe verbal from you at any given time, whatever your behaviour might be. I think we've all potentially got different ways that we would determine a reaction that seems a little bit off the cuff. And the way that I would describe that would be that the reaction doesn't really suit the situations. So it's a bit over the top, it's a bit full on, it seems like the trigger is not really relative to the reaction, it seems quite exaggerated, their reaction to whatever the trigger might be, but there's a reason for it. So one of the things that we know about emotions is if they're not managed properly, they don't go away. Unfortunately, you may think that when you're dismissing or avoiding emotions, that you are somehow escaping or avoiding that emotional experience. Psych Chrissy's here to tell you guys that, unfortunately, that is not true. Effectively, what happens is that you pick up a backpack and you start storing emotions in your backpack. Now, that might be you know, a little bit of frustration, a little bit of annoyance, a little bit of anger, a little bit of overwhelm, chuck in a little bit of stress. So all day throughout our day, we are having emotional fluctuations. As humans, we can't avoid it. We're emotional beings. We have responses to a whole range of things throughout our day. Now, if we don't attend to our emotional state, that is, if we don't sort of check in on ourselves or notice how we're feeling, what happens when you start packing too many oranges in the backpack? It bloody overflows, guys. So same with emos, same with emotions. If you dismiss and avoid your emotional experiences, effectively, you start packing them into an emotional backpack, which what happens is that sooner or later, that's right, guys, the backpack freaking explodes. So our flip outs and our freak outs are a culmination of emotions that have not been tended to or managed appropriately. So we build up and we build up and we build up. We avoid, dismiss, we don't attend to what's going on. And then we have a freak out, flip out moment where all of our emotions seem to come to the surface at once. Have you ever heard of that notion of the straw that broke the camel's back? Well, that is so true for emotional management. If you don't be managing your emotions properly, what happens is one little straw seems to then create a whole explosion of straws, aka emotions, and it might just be in response to something that is quite minor. You know, so the trick is that we really do need to pay attention as to what's going on for ourselves emotionally at any given time. Unfortunately for a lot of people, sometimes they don't learn how to tend to different emotions. Emotional awareness can be poor. Our emotional vocabularies might be really, really limited. We just fail to acknowledge the early warning signs that our emotions are happening and they're starting to build. So there's a whole range of things. Hey, Cara, welcome to Life Crusher Live. So Chrissy's talking about flip outs and why they tend to happen. But there's a whole range of, I suppose, difficulties or deficits that we tend to have in emotional functioning that contribute to the major flip out moments. So it does take a bit, you know, it may be that you need to learn how to label and describe emotions. And I know that for a lot of you, you might go, well, that's easy. If I'm angry, I just say I'm angry. But it's more to it than that. It's your ability to notice, you know, the smaller frustrations, be able to name that, acknowledge that it's happened, notice what's going on in your environment, notice what sort of physiological symptoms that you might be getting. It might be a headache, you know, it could be less obvious symptoms like feeling a little bit irritable or having, you know, heart palpitations, noticing a sore or a tight chest. You know, there could be a whole range. It could be anxiety related symptoms. There could be a number of indicators that are suggesting to you that your emotions are starting to build. A panic attack, for example, is a significant buildup of anxiety. So often I'll talk to my clients and they'll say to me, "Psych Chrissy, my panic attacks really do come out of nowhere." I'm always very sus on that. And what it normally is that they're failing to recognize the buildup. So they're not noticing their anxiety building throughout their day. They're dismissing and avoiding emotional experiences. And then all of a sudden, bang, the heart rate increases. They become short of breath. They become really panicked and stressed out. And then a panic attack arises. So it's the same with anger flip outs. You will be receiving a number of early warning signs that that is happening throughout the day. Some of the common ones that I will see for people is that they will start overthinking things, for example. Someone who they might reasonably get along with, they start to get a little bit snappy or a little bit shirty. They might get frustrated with small tasks or things that they're doing throughout the day. So there's these little indicators that your emotional experiences are starting to build. Now, the other thing that can happen too is that when we have a flip out moment with certain people, it may be that your flip out has got actually nothing whatsoever to do with that person at all. So, for example, for all the mums out there, and look, this could be legit. You flip out at your kids could literally be a build-up of frustration and annoyance at your kids, but it also could be symptomatic of other things that are going on in your life that you are not managing very well. So, you know, and I often deal with parents that will say to me, oh my God, I feel so bad. I just lost it at the kids and, you know, I don't really know why. And, you know, and then they tell me about, you know, a whole range of stresses that might be going on in their lives. Like it might be financial, it might be employment, workplace related. It might be their own relationships that are suffering. And then all of a sudden, the kids, you know, knock something over and it's like, rah! You know, and you have this really over the top sort of reaction. What we would call that in psychology land is deflection. So you're actually not channeling the anger and the frustration at the source or the cause. It just happens to be the thing in the moment that tips you over the edge. It just happens to be the trigger, but not necessarily the source of where the frustration and the anger and the stress and overwhelm is actually coming from. And we do that from time to time. We do tend to take it out on the trigger that happens in the moment, but it's not necessarily the trigger that we're feeling frustrated with. It could be a whole range of different things that are impacting on our ability to self-regulate and really keep a lid on that frustration and that build-up. So it is really important, guys, that, you know, if you struggle, if you are going from this 0 to 10 in 2 seconds flat, there's probably a number of things that potentially could be happening for you. You probably need to work on your emotional awareness and your identification. You probably need to get better at noticing your early warning signs. It's not just 10. There will be physiological indicators. So are there things going on in your body or signals that you might not be managing things very well? Are there little behavioral indicators? Are you getting more irritable? Are you snapping at people? Are you is your frustration tolerance reducing? You know, so there will be a number of warning signs that are tapping you on the shoulder and saying, hey, maybe you're not managing your emotions very well. Is there something different that you need to be doing right now to make sure that you can manage yourself? You know, so emotional awareness and identification, noticing the early warning signs, and then being able to address the buildup. You know, so checking back in on yourself. How am I feeling? Why am I feeling this way? Is there something that I need to be doing different? Do I need a time out? Do I need to go outside and take some deep breaths? Do I need a drink of water? Do I need to remove myself from a situation? You know, there's lots of options there for you. You don't have to keep staying in the moment where, you know, your frustration is likely to keep building. Sometimes it might be about removing yourself from that situation and taking a time out. Because what can happen is if you are able to de-escalate, so bring your mood down, whether it be via breathing, mindfulness, time out, all of those little bits and pieces that I just mentioned, you could effectively be at the cusp of a flip out. So let's say you could be at, I don't know, 6 out of 10 annoyance. Now, if you go and implement a strategy like that, it's not going to get you to 0. Don't get me wrong there. You know, the stresses may still be there. But what you could potentially do is bring yourself down to maybe a 3 or a 4. And what that means is that you've got far more leg room or room to move before you hit the danger zone. Now, the danger zone really is the 8, 9, 10 out of 10 emotional intensity. You know, and often if you get rage regret, you know, you lose it, and then later on you think, oh my God, geez, why did I do that? You get some rage regret. It's all the more reason why you should really learn how to be more emotionally aware, learn how to identify your emotions and check back in on yourself, and really get motivated to put some strategies in place so that you don't take things out on people that potentially don't deserve it, so you don't look like the office psycho or whatever it is that you're trying to manage, so that you don't, you know, act out on your relationships or your kids, or, you know, or so you just don't feel bad for some of your reactions. There are options there for you to take, but The number one rule is, guys, and the parting message for today is that if you are flipping out, you really need to learn how to check back in on yourself emotionally. You need to become more aware. You need to be more capable and competent in recognizing emotional buildup before you get to that level and be able to put strategies in place so that you can actually bring your emotional state down. So there we go, guys. I want you all thinking about how you can manage your emotional buildup more effectively. What is it that you need to do more of? How do you become more aware? Should you be checking in on yourself a little bit more often around how you're feeling at any given time? Should you be taking more breaks throughout the day? Should you be doing more mindfulness? Should you be going to yoga? Should you be doing some breathing exercises? Should you download a mindfulness app? That's always an awesome option. My favorite at the moment is the Insight Timer. So if you haven't got that, guys, go to the App Store or Google Play and download the Insight Timer. It's a really cool little mindfulness app that allows you to just set all your own time, pick your own music. You can track your day-to-day progress on your mindfulness. Really cool app. So if you haven't got it, go get it. All right, guys, and stop flipping out. Let's get on top of this. Let's start managing our emotions more effectively and being more aware of how we're feeling at any given time. So there we go, guys. I hope that has been helpful. I hope that has got you thinking about how to manage your emotions more effectively. And I'll see you guys all next Tuesday for the next Life Crusher Live. Catch you guys. Thanks for joining.